I'm Matt Gutierrez, and with me today is Yankin Tanerhan. We're going to be talking about the emerging trends in the very dynamic automotive market and the evolving processor IP requirements for in-vehicle application. So let's get started. Yankin, of course, the concept of autonomous vehicles is not new, but they are getting more and more real, right? Many cars on the road today already have driver assistance features like adaptive cruise control, lane guidance, active braking. But what do you think it's going to take to get to the next level of autonomous driving in the next couple of years?
Yes, Matt. The automotive industry continues to push to develop autonomous vehicles, or trying to give more and more autonomy to the vehicles, and the systems are getting increasingly complex. A larger number and a greater variety of sensors are being integrated to provide this autonomy and a more comprehensive picture of the driving environment, which is at the end critical to achieve this independence of the car. For example, a vehicle might use LiDAR, radar, and ultrasound and infrared sensors, all integrated as well as cameras for object detection, along with something called scene segmentation. The purpose is not just to track and identify objects. Obviously, the ability to differentiate a pedestrian, for instance, from a building or an advertisement or a car is important. But that's just the starting point, because you want to be able to predict what that pedestrian or the car is doing next, and understand what these objects' role are within the context of the scene. And of course, all this image and sensor data, and in some cases even sound, requires a tremendous amount of processing power to be done within the vehicle. We are talking pretty heavy-hitting computers now as central processing engines in the cars. And the latency of going to the cloud to do some of that processing cannot be tolerated. So for most of these tasks, they had to be handled locally, or even if distributed within the car itself. And if you are looking at all that computation, there is one tricky element, and that's what you have to still factor the safety as a critical component, as part of that requirements, how to manage all the incoming data.
Thank you for watching this video, and please join us in the next segment to hear about how vehicle safety requirements have an impact all the way down to the processor architecture.